Hi, going to be talking about clarity and using all sides of your personality to live in the world. Now, when you live in the world, people will tell you you have to be a very good person and all that. It's not right. You should be like a cat outside a rat hole. That is the ideal kind of non-duality you should be. Calm but ready for a moment to take on anything. Now, when you live in the world, how do you decide what is good for you? Because you don't know what is good for you. You should see what you naturally do, what naturally comes out for you. If you naturally start being a marketing person, then marketing is your line. If you naturally are somebody who starts writing, then writing is your line. Whatever naturally comes out from you and is your natural process, and you naturally go there. You may take a path of yoga, you may take a path of art, you may take a path of business, you may take a path of kung fu, karate. Any path which naturally comes to you and you love doing it, follow that path. Follow the path that you love and then blindly follow it. Every path will have its hurdles. It's not going to be a bed of roses, but when you listen to people, everybody will tell you, look at that, look at that, look at that. You will get confused and the world will only make you confused. Once you get what you're doing, just blindly follow it. Then be careful and very careful of your person. Be sensitive to vibrations. If you ever feel any place people have not understood you or are trying to think that you're a fool or making a fool of you, never disturb them again. Put a value to a person, to your person. You're the only person who can put a value to yourself. Nobody else can. That's what will give you value in the market as who you are. The value will be realized one day. You don't have to worry, but put a strong value on your person. Be humble, yes, but also with a certain ready to take on, as I said, like a cat outside a rat hole. I will tell you a beautiful fable. There was once a cobra which terrorized a village, and the villagers were very scared because it kept biting people. So they went and spoke to a godman to go and talk to the cobra that stop biting people. They all don't know how to live with that cobra in the village. So the godman agreed and went and met the cobra and told the cobra to stop biting people. The cobra agreed. Peace descended in the village and the cobra stopped biting people and everybody were happy and peace. Then about after 10 to 15 days, some young people were playing in the field and they saw the cobra basking in the sun. And one guy said, hey, isn't that the cobra that used to bite? Let's get it. So they took sticks and stones and started attacking the cobra. The cobra, badly hurt, just managed to escape and ran off to its hole. When the godman heard of this, he was very upset. So he went to meet the cobra again. The cobra came out of its den and the godman said, what happened, cobra? He says, look, I stopped biting people and look what your people have done. They nearly killed me. Well, the godman said, brother, I asked you to stop biting people, not to stop hissing. It's an old Indian fable with a lot of wisdom. So in life, you need even to be all sides of your personality to live. Just being the nice person, people will tread over you. You have to make sure that you're pungent, that you're something that people are scared to just play around with. And for that, you have to make your boundaries, put your boundaries very clear. So don't bite people, be a good person, but don't stop hissing. You have to keep that side of your personality alive to live in the world. Everybody is given certain defenses, and those defenses are there for you to how to live in this world. So I was trying to get across about clarity of what you're doing and how you have to use all sides of your personality to live in the world.